It's vlog time once again. I am here today on Sunday. Oh man, I was just like trying, I was building up to that for ages because I wanted to sound really dramatic. It's Sunday. I can't read the date on my phone, guys. Can I read the date on here? Where's the date? Is the date over here? Ah, joys of having eyesight like this. Let's zoom in. Sunday the 24th of May. That's right, Sunday the 24th of May. I knew that. And I'm at home, and I'm doing a little bit of work today, because I'm going to do a couple of things ready for the week, because it's going to be a busy week for me, and I will explain why, but first, check out this weather. As you can see, guys, let me twist that a little bit. No? Is that a bit better? Hang on. I don't really know. The sky is totally, totally grey. And it is very damp and not very nice out there. Although the roads are looking fairly dry at the moment, it is still quite damp and disgusting. We may go outside later and take a look at what's happening. It is sort of drizzle, not nice weather. I'm not sure if you guys say the word drizzle in America. I'm really not sure. In Wales, a lot of people say, in terms of that kind of light rain, a lot of people say, oh, it's picking. They say, you know, oh, it's picking outside. It's a little bit damp. It's picking, it is. And, you know, obviously they're trying to say it's picking with rain. It's picking. I never say that because I sound like an idiot saying it with my sort of semi-crap accent. But, yeah, this vlog is going to run pretty much throughout the entirety of the week, guys. Maybe a little bit less than the week, because there should be a few exciting things happening. Nothing totally groundbreaking, but it should be fairly cool. I did start recording a vlog last week, but it was a crapper than crap. It was so boring. I was just like, what in the hell is that? I've begun editing it. I can kind of see the project from here. There we are. It's in the sidebar in Final Cut. And I was like, no, what are you doing? So of course, the center of attention this week is this glorious setup. I cannot begin to stress how much Todd has made me happy. He's absolutely made my week. I was pretty crappy feeling, guys, and now I'm feeling awesome about this. You know, sometimes it doesn't matter how hard life gets, just getting new geeky toys, especially two awesome Dell monitors. These monitors are stunning, guys. It's enough to make your day. It really, really is. So, although I had a triple display setup before, and now I've got this setup, there is a massive, massive difference, you know. Having them all match, for starters, is excellent. And the same resolution means that when I drag windows to other displays and that, everything remains the same. It's proper, it's brilliant. It's a nice setup. I cannot stress how nice it is. Oh, man, it is so nice. At the moment, I'm editing the, what video is this? This is the desk rearrangement. I've just started, as you can see, there is my intro. So I've literally just started editing it. There are all the clips. I think this video is going to be about 20 minutes to half an hour long, which should be great. People love these kind of videos. And this is obviously Monday's video, so you guys have seen it by now. This vlog will be uploaded on Thursday, probably. So we're working a little bit kind of like back in time at the moment. But I wanted to start vlogging today because I got a pretty cool couple of things to do, especially in terms of online pre-orders and stuff. We'll talk about it in a second. So the question is, guys, why am I going to be busy this week? Well, it is... Man, that glass was stuck to the coaster. It is bank holiday tomorrow, so that means... Actually, it doesn't mean anything. It just means that it's coinciding with half term. So all the kids are off school, and that means in the cinema, we have extra films. We have matinees showing 1 and 3 and stuff like that. I'm not even sure on the times yet. I haven't looked. So I'm always more busy. I'm showing more films in the holidays. But luckily, I only work... Mondays and Wednesdays showing films, so I should be able to still have quite a bit of time to do various things, although I will be working potentially Thursday and Friday afternoon as well, but that's okay, I can deal with that. I'm just gonna get a nice big glass of water, guys, because I woke up last night all really, really thirsty, and I had a bottle of water next to me, but it only had a little bit of water in it, and you know when you're so tired, you just fall straight back asleep after having a tiny sip of water or whatever.
The reason why I was so tired is because I stayed up late playing Splatoon. The Splatoon test fire was rad, guys. And I'm actually making an IMNC rant video about it. You guys will have seen it because I believe it'll be Tuesday's video. I'm actually going to rant about how people were complaining so much about the servers being down. I mean, guys, it was a test fire. I mean, obviously you've seen the rant video by now, so you know, I'm not going to rant too much in the vlog, but the whole point of a test fire is so that, you know, they can stress test the servers. That was the whole point of it. So the servers went down, okay, cool, and then they were an hour late, but we had an hour of Splatoon play, so we had exactly what we promised, and we probably helped troubleshoot their servers because they went down initially. So that makes me all the more confident for the launch on the 29th, and I am happy. But anyway, I digress. I had a pizza last night while playing Splatoon, I had the pizza while I was waiting to play Splatoon, and when I was playing Squid Jump, and yeah, that was just awesome, but I got really dehydrated in the middle of the night because, like an idiot, I didn't drink enough water. One interesting fact about me, guys, I don't really drink fizzy pop. There was a time when I was about 14 and I said, I'm not going to drink fizzy pop. And James will actually tell you this. I don't know if he's watching or whatever, but if he comments below. Yeah, I gave up fizzy pop and I didn't drink any fizzy drinks for like a year or something, a year or two. And then I started treating myself to the odd one here and there, got back into drinking them, and when I was in college then, when I was around 16, 17, I started drinking Coca-Cola like crazy, and I was drinking a lot of Coca-Cola, you know, I'd have big bottles of it in my bag and stuff, and then I was like, you know what, no way. I gave up fizzy pop again, after I think just as I came out of college or whatever, but of course I was drinking by then, so obviously, you know, beer and stuff, you know, lager and that is fizzy and stuff, so that didn't really count, but yeah, you kind of know what I mean, you know. I don't really drink a lot of fizzy pop. This has been a random story. Oh man, this has been so random, but anyway guys, it's totally whatever. Just realized I didn't finish my story. Idiot. Where was I? Yes, so yesterday, because of the whole Splatoon thing and that, and you know, it's the weekend, and I knew I was going to be working hard this week, I thought, you know what, I'm going to treat myself to a couple of tins of pop, and I got an apple tango with my pizza, and I also drank a lemon Fanta, and I get severely dehydrated when I drink fizzy drinks. I don't know why. So obviously, that was 660 millilitres of fizzy drink, so not a lot. Well, it is kind of a lot, but yeah, it kind of affects me really badly. It affects my skin, and I just don't like the feeling of my teeth, even after brushing my teeth for days after drinking fizzy drinks. I don't like it. So yeah, today I'm fully on the water, and I'm going to keep topping myself up like crazy. So obviously I was getting in with the crowd when I was playing Splatoon, and I was like, ah man, you know, the servers are down. But I did say everyone needs to calm down and give Nintendo a break, you know, I tweeted that. There were people saying things like, oh man, if Nintendo don't get the servers up for the test fire, I'm not going to pre-order the game, I'm going to cancel my pre-order. I was like, what the hell, you know? So I kind of played along with all the hype and obviously did a well-deserved post when I was actually playing the game. If you want to follow me on Instagram, by the way, guys, it is in the video description. So yes, we are still pretty much in the intro of the vlog, I suppose, but I've kind of merged the intro in with the rest of it. Today's plan for me is very simple, guys. I'm going to edit the video, Monday's video, record Tuesday's video, hopefully edit Tuesday's video so that I am done up to Tuesday. That means that any free space of time I get on Monday or Tuesday I can use to make Wednesday's video, and that is me pretty much in the clear for the week then in terms of YouTube, because Thursday's video will be this vlog and I'll just keep vlogging continuously, and Friday's video is going to be a special video with my dad this week, I believe, and we are going to do that on Thursday. You guys are going to love that, I think. It's such a crazy idea, but it's going to be cool. So the plan is for today, like I said, edit the video, record Tuesday's videos, video, edit Tuesday's video maybe, but that doesn't really matter. I can edit whenever. And one of my other goals is to not completely tidy my room, but get the room a little bit tidy. I believe Wednesday's video, I'm going to try and make it about my test bench little setup.
Because I've now set up this Dell 2009W on that pole, as you guys will see in Monday's video, but you've already seen it. Yeah.
But as you can see by all that mess, I really need to sort it out, and I want to get some kind of nice, you know, nice setup there. Which I think will be really good for testing PCs and stuff. Definitely really, really cool. And it looks cool as well. But, yeah, the tidying the room thing may not happen. I always say I'm going to. But I am going to shut the hell up now and go and edit this video and see how far I get. And then as a reward for editing the video, I'm going to get some hype going and I'm going to pre-order my limited edition copy of Splatoon with the amiibo on Amazon so that I get it on the 29th. Because, man, that test fire was awesome. I missed the first one. That one was awesome. What a freaking awesome game. I thoroughly enjoyed myself.
Ah, I love the feeling when you get to the end of an edit and you are proud with a video. This video is by no means perfect. I've got a lot of weird camera reflections and out of focus bits and stuff, but the pure nature of a video like this is classic IMNC, rearranging a desk setup, but with a twist, and that twist is my desk setup is no longer, you know, it used to be pretty crappy back in the day, you know, let's admit, when I had one of those older 20-inch Dell monitors. I had my Mac Pro, which was the best part, obviously. You know, crappy mouse, crappy keyboard. Well, I had the Apple keyboard. You know, it was nothing special. But now it is turning into something that, you know, you can really, really start to call an ultimate setup. Because someone asked me, why do you call your desk setup ultimate? I can't believe if... I can't remember if I've answered that in a Q&A yet or not. But, you know, I call it ultimate because it's ultimate to me. I work my ass off getting my setup this nice, and it's so... I feel so proud when I make a video like this. Also, pleased with the thumbnail. There was a great point in the video where the thumbnail just looked excellent, and it shows off the three monitors there. It looks really, really good. And check it out, guys. Let's be fair. That is one hell of a lot of awesome screen space to do this work on. Really, really cool. And here we are. I am sharing as a QuickTime file. I export in full quality if anyone's interested. Absolute full quality from Final Cut, and then I use Handbrake for my compression. That is the best workflow that I have found. I believe I've done that method since the start of using Final Cut. It just takes too long and there's not enough options in Final Cut to compress. And I did use compressor for a little while, but it's way too slow. Handbrake is much quicker. Even though compressor's much more of a pro application, I just don't need its features. And of course, since I updated Yosemite, my version of compressor does not work anyway. But here we are, exporting. Now, I've previewed this, obviously, as I've been editing it. I don't understand people that export a video and then preview it in QuickTime afterwards, because if you've made a mistake, you have to re-export the whole video. And I've seen a couple of YouTubers do that. Now, fair enough, watch your QuickTime project after it's been exported if you want to, but normally I just watch 30 seconds from a couple of different areas. So I watch about a minute and a half of it when it's come out of Final Cut, and then again when it's come out of Handbrake, just to make sure there's nothing wrong with the video, because sometimes things can go wrong, you know, when exporting and stuff, you never know. But in terms of checking if you've made any mistakes in editing, you know, you've missed out a clip or you've done a really naff cut and you didn't notice it first time round, you know, preview it in Final Cut, because at least then you can change it without exporting again. But, you know, what do I know? I've only got 12,000 subscribers. I'm not exactly up there with the gods of YouTube, so I'm not even going to comment on it. But, yeah, I'm happy with my little community, guys. If you ever hear me saying, oh, I've only got 12,000 subscribers, that's not me being sad at all.
That is me being the complete opposite. I am so happy with the community that we have here with It's My Natural Colour. It is just amazing, to tell you the truth.
I think it's raining a little bit more.
Yeah, it is raining a little bit more. It's not picking anymore. It's not picking. You guys have learned a new thing about Wales today. There are some odd things we say here. Very odd things. But before I ramble on any longer, let's change desktops. Leave the pro desktop. Go back to my web browser and mail and stuff. And we have got some very exciting work to do. I'm not going to call it work. I can never ever justify it as work. We've got some very exciting fun things to do with some Amazon pre-ordering.
So if you guys type in Splatoon to Amazon, you can see it is number one at the moment in Wii U. People are pre-ordering it like mad. Of course, there are two versions. You've got the Splatoon with the amiibo. This is like the special edition one. And then you've got the regular copy. There's a £10 difference. I think it's, yeah, roughly £10. It's come down a little bit since I last looked. Hang on a second. Yes, they've both gone down a shade. This one has gone down a little bit more. That's actually gone down a considerable amount more. This has just gone down like 25p or 24p. But if we take a look at this, this is currently available for pre-order and it'll be released May 29th. If we go back and take a look at this, this is the same. Now, I do not own any amiibos, guys, and maybe getting a Splatoon amiibo is kind of like not the most exciting thing as your first amiibo, but I never buy brand new games. I buy a brand new game. Well, obviously I buy brand new games, but I mean brand new release games. I never pay the top whack for a game. Never, ever. £40 is crazy. And the thing is with the Wii U, you've got to wait a long time for the games to come down. So what I'm going to do to treat myself, I literally buy games at this price about once every 2 years, guys. I am going to pre-order this. And it's going to come, it's going to be in this box, and I'm going to do a nice unboxing. And do you know what? I'm going to pre-order the damn thing because I think it's going to be totally rad. I love this game. I think it's really cool. I want to support Nintendo as much as I can. So I'm going to pre-order it at full whack. And if I choose first-class delivery, pay a couple of quid for that, I'll get it on May 29th with all the hype. I will be part of the hype, which is an exciting prospect because I am often quite behind the times. So to be current with something is a big difference for me. But anyway, that's quantity one pre-order. Boom. We shall pre-order it. Item is added to your basket. I'm going to proceed to check out. And in my basket at the moment, guys, I've got to sign in.
I can't point the camera at the screen anymore, guys, because my address and card information and phone number and everything is littered across the screen naturally. But have a listen to this. Check this out. And this is why I love Amazon sometimes. Sometimes I hate Amazon, sometimes I love Amazon. Now, of course, it is currently May the 24th, and this game doesn't come out until May the 29th, so I'm pre-ordering, right? And have a listen to this. Our pre-order price guarantee covers one or more items in your order. Our price order price guarantee... Oh, sorry, just read the same thing twice. The price you pay will be the lowest price offered by Amazon.co.uk between the time you place your order up to and including the date the item is dispatched. When the item... hang on a sec. Where have I lost? Yeah. Where the item has a stated release date, if your order enters the dispatch process before that date and the price of the item drops below the price you were charged between the date of dispatch and the release date, we'll automatically refund your payment card for the difference. Now that is awesome. They are basically saying, that basically means, you know how Amazon prices fluctuate? Sometimes they fluctuate by just like 20p all the time, or sometimes they can fluctuate like £4 or £5. This game won't. Maximum £1 this game will fluctuate. That means that even though you're ordering it now, they will refund you, no matter if your order has been sent for process or not, processing and dispatch, they will refund you all the way up until the 29th, which is awesome. So it's likely that Amazon will be sending me around 30p or whatever. It does not mention anything about the other way around if the game goes up or whatever, but that's great because they wouldn't be able to do that. They can give you money back, but they can't demand more money after you've ordered. So that's great. So here I have it. I'm also ordering a pen drive at the same time, guys. So that is knocking the order up a little bit. But let's take a look. I'm going to do 1 day delivery because I believe that's the one you take. They dispatch on the 28th and then I'll get it on the 29th. If I take dispatch items when they become available, that means the pen drive won't hold back my order, which is great. And let's take a look. Wow, okay. Holy crap, guys. Postage and packaging at $12.98. Holy crap. Wait a sec, if I press group items, $7.99. Okay. Order total. Holy crap, guys. Holy crap. That's quite expensive. First class, $3.99. Order total 4876. That's cool. For a pen drive, brand new game pre-order, and delivery. Buy now. Yes, please. I hope I've selected the right delivery. I selected first class, so it should be fine. They'll get it to me anyway. They'll get it to me. So, that is it. I want to share that on Twitter. Oh, I can't. Review or edit your order. I wanted to share that I'd bought the game, but it only let me share the damn bloody pen drive. That's crap. Anyway, that is it. I am pre-ordered. It is on the way. Hang on, I've just had the email. Auto confirmation. Hello, thank you for your order. Awesome. Ah, wicked. I can tweet from the email. I shall do that in a second. Boom. There it is. My tweet. I didn't do the official Amazon tweet because it sucked, so I made my own full of hashtags and @.
It is 1 o'clock, so I'm pretty proud of myself for managing to get that video edited and whatnot all in this time. Got a nice video produced. I did think that, I did think of something, and that is I could, in fact, easily not record Tuesday's video today, my Splatoon test fire rant. I could record that tomorrow because I'm in work tomorrow from 2:30 until 10 o'clock. So I could easily record it in the morning, which would be great. However, it's quite a long shift in work and I'm going to be working on my emails and Facebook messages in work. I'll talk about that in a second, by the way, guys. I'm going to be working on that lot there, so I don't want to stress myself out too much, so I would rather do the video today. I'm having a top up on water, by the way, guys. I would rather do the video today, but I'm sort of looking at the time. I can't see the clock. Yeah, it's 1 o'clock. And I'm thinking, I ideally want to get chilling, you know, because it's bank holiday. I ideally want to get chilling by sort of 4, 5. I don't want to do anything really. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm not going out to the pub, by the way, guys. I'm just not doing it. I don't know why. I don't fancy losing 40 or 50 quid in one night again and then feeling rough as hell tomorrow, because every bank holiday Monday I go out, but then I feel rough as hell and I've got to work all day on Monday. So I would do it, but the summer is right around the corner and there will be plenty of opportunities to get wasted over the summer. So yeah, I'll do that instead of going out tonight. And I'm feeling quite good about that decision, you know? I'm feeling really good. Plus, I had a pizza last night, like I said. And I spoke a lot about the dehydration thing with the fizzy drinks that I had. But what I didn't speak about is the fact that I'm dairy intolerant. And of course, there's cheese on pizza. Luckily, they kind of skimp on the cheese from where we order from because they're really cheap and nasty. So they skimp quite a lot on the cheese, which is good for me because I am dairy intolerant and that's why I get these rashes on my face. And that's a lot of the reason, guys. My skin gets bad for various reasons, but mainly dairy, and it also affects me in lots of other ways. So I'm wandering around the house. Do you know what, guys? I'm going to swap arms. Is this going to be too... well, okay. Oh, that's better. My arm. I don't know why I never swap arms. Using the camera with my right arm just seems weird. But I guess I used to use it. No, I used to use my left arm with my camcorder. Yeah, this doesn't feel right. I can't vlog properly using this arm. Anyway, I need to get myself some food going because, man, I am hungry. I am really, really hungry. And once I eat, I may feel more inspired to do my Splatoon test fire rant video, IMNC rants. I haven't done one in a long time as well, so it's I want to do it. No, Tom, don't wander out of the kitchen and go berserk. It's not that I'm not motivated to do it, it's just because my room isn't tidy. It's a lot of effort with the tripod and that. I tell you what I will do, guys. Stuff it. I'll get some food, have a little chill with some food, then I will tidy my room, record the video. I won't stress about editing it today. I'll edit it tomorrow. Boom. It's only going to take about 10-15 minutes to record, so no big deal at all. I've got like 3 hours, or 2, 3, 4, yeah, 3 hours. I want to be done by 4, 5 o'clock latest. And I'm going to vamoose, I'm going to make like a tree. I'm going to go down Jess's house, enjoy some films, take it easy, and enjoy my bank holiday Sunday
pre-bank holiday Monday. Ice cream van. Excellent. Anyway, that's a good cue to shut the hell up, isn't it?
Oh yeah, baby. Jacket potatoes. Don't you just love it when you open the fridge? And this is great. If you've been away for a couple of days, you open the fridge and boom, there is food that has been pre-prepared for me. So I don't have to make my own crappy food. I can enjoy this food. So check out this first person potato action, okay? Look at this. Motion controls at their finest. Anyway, by the way, guys, that's one awesome thing about Splatoon. The motion controls, I thought I would hate them because I hate motion controls. I'm not going to beat around the bush. I love Nintendo. How long do you put these in for? 2.5 minutes? I don't know. Anyway, whatever. I love Nintendo, don't get me wrong.
And of course, the Wii was a massive success, like, you know, colossally successful console. At least, well, it sold a lot. But motion controls and me, nah, not too keen. Although I have not really given it the time of day anywhere in the last 3 years, to tell you the truth, guys. I don't have Wiimotes for my Wii U. Jess has a Wiimote. She's got the red one because she had the special edition Wii and the 25th anniversary of something, was it? I can't remember what it was, 30th anniversary of something. The really nice limited edition red Wii, which is a gorgeous looking console. So she's got that Wiimote, but we literally only use it, the Bluetooth functionality, to play Mario Kart. You know, I don't have an infrared sensor bar set up. With my Wii U, it's still in the box. It's still in the box. I've noticed that I'm getting worse and worse at talking, by the way, guys. As I'm getting older, I'm getting worse. Same goes for writing. I was better at writing when I was in school. When I have to write something on paper now, I'm like, what is this craziness? And I can barely do it. But yeah, I've got a knife out. I'm also going bizarre. Guys, I'm just a massive, massive fail at the moment. I can't talk, I can't write, I can't even do things properly. I don't even know how long to put a potato in the microwave for. They smell good. Maybe they'll need a little bit more time than this. But yeah, back to the motion controls. I absolutely love them. They're great. I like the way you can use the analog stick from side to side, and it also kind of works a little bit with the motion controls. It'll take me a while to get used to it. I'm not used to it, but I like them. That's an important differentiating point, contrasting point, you know, it's an important balance factor to make. Jesus Christ, guys, what the hell am I on about?
There they are, jacket potatoes with a rubbish filling that I made, but so, so nice.
I do like my different types of cheeses. By the way, guys, I've got three things to carry up. Camera, water, and dinner, so I'll leave it there for now. I love different varieties of cheeses, as you could probably see there. That was like that sort of moldy-looking cheese. Like I said, I'm dairy intolerant, but thankfully there's a lot of cheese available that is not, you know, cow's milk-based, which is really great. So I believe that one is sheep's cheese, and it is so nice, so, so, so nice. Cheese is one of my favourite things to eat, and I love all the different varieties in that. And we've normally always got cheese in the house, and that's one thing I'm going to be not looking forward to when I move out, is I'm obviously going to be quite poor for a little bit, you know, until the business really takes off, if it ever takes off. And that means I won't be able to splash out on like cheese all the time. I'll almost have to live like a student, you know. But at least if you haven't got a dairy intolerance, you can buy really cheap cheese, and it's still cheese, so you can have like cheese on toast and cheese sandwiches and whatever you have. But you're not paying loads of money. But unfortunately, anything slightly out of the ordinary, which is the way in this world, you know, anything slightly out of the ordinary, like goat's cheese or whatever, is more expensive, so that's a little bit annoying. But as you can see, guys, even though I'm a nerd, I get plenty of exercise by walking up and down the stairs daily, multiple times. I'm obviously joking, guys. I cycle a lot and everything, so I am not as unhealthy as you may think. My arm is gonna die.
So, pretty cool, guys. Just got done eating my grub and I watched Max X Arcade's latest two videos. Awesome stuff. Wicked, wicked channel, you know. I just wished that I had the resources and knowledge to be able to make the types of videos that he makes, you know. His videos are really, really cool. They make mine look like toy videos in comparison, if that makes any sense. Like, I understand the majority of what he talks about in his videos, but to actually put that into practice in terms of like amplifier repair and things like that, you know, I'm just not that good at electronics. And of course then the whole soldering and eyesight thing comes into it. So it's a big shame. I'd love to be, you know, I quite look up to this guy in a way. He's a great, great guy. I really like him. And there was a lot revealed about him in his Q&A. And that was also really quite a sort of like a touching Q&A as well, because of how honest he was about everything. And it just goes to show the variety of the different types of people that are out there. But yeah, his videos are phenomenal. And his subscriber rate increase is nice. Really, really nice. He's got a nice curve up on his subscribers. He's getting the views that he deserves. You know, he deserves even more. But in terms of the people on YouTube that like tinkering with this stuff, he gets a great, great selection of views, you know. So yeah, just a little plug there, actually, because he doesn't watch my videos. You know, my videos are probably definitely the wrong style for him to watch. But just a quick plug there, because just because of how cool his videos are. Guys, there was a policeman standing outside of my house. Hang on a sec. Whoa, shit. Turn my light off. Just staring at my house, what the hell? Hang on a sec, guys, sorry for the cruddy camera work, but yeah, whoa, there is actually, what the hell is happening down there? I know you can't see anything, guys. But yeah, something was happening. He was just staring. I don't want to be seen to be filming, you know. Although you are allowed to film whatever you want. Okay, he's gone. That was really weird. That was so odd. I just saw him out the corner of my eye because he's in high visibility, obviously. That was really odd. He was just staring at my dad's truck down there. It's crazy. Really weird. Anyway, I'm watching LGR's video on AOL, and I've actually missed out on a little bit of it now because I muted instead of pausing, which was odd. But yeah, I don't need to know how to do it anyway. AOL is such an interesting phenomenon.
As you guys know, AOL has been bought out by Verizon, which I found really interesting news. And what I found more interesting was the fact that the majority of their income comes from dial-up customers. And is it like a crazy statistic? Like, there are 2 something million dial-up customers in the US, and each of them gives on average $29 a month to AOL still. That is crazy. Especially considering, you know, fair enough, in remote locations, you know, you can get, that's, you know, dial-up is the only thing you can get or whatever, but there have been massive advancements in things like satellite broadband and radio, what do they call it? Like, when broadband is beamed wirelessly over a certain area, I don't even know what all this stuff is because I'm not really that familiar, you know, because we can get broadband here. But yeah, I just find it crazy how there are so many dial-up customers. There must be elderly customers, I think, most of them. You know, that are happy to sit there and wait, and they've got plenty of money, so I really don't know what the score is. But anyway, guys, I've been chilling here for a little while. It is 2:00, and I have a snap from Jack. Let's have a look what he says. Jack. And, wonderful, tonight. He does a slanty smiley face. Tonight's office, 11 bands. Don't know if you guys can see that, but he loves it. He's sitting in front of a big digital desk there. It looked like an Allen & Heath GLD or something, but I don't really know my way around big digital desks. I don't know which ones are which. But yeah, he's like, oh man, 11 bands, cry. But he absolutely loves it. It's what he lives for. What a legend. Anyway, you guys haven't seen Jack in a while now. Not since my most unpopular vlog of all time, I believe. That's the last time you saw Jack. Anyway, guys, I'm getting sidetracked now. I'm going to begin tidying my bedroom.
Nearly done. It is done. If anyone is curious, I compress straight to the RAID array these days and upload from there because I'm still in my stage of testing out the stability of this enclosure. So far, it has been nothing but rock solid. It feels like you're using the internal drive of the Mac Mini. It is so rock solid, just a little slower than using the internal drive of the Mac Mini, of course, as you guys saw from the video, and it sparked a whole discussion video about it. I'm surprised at the stability of the Western Digital Caviar SEs as well, considering they're quite old, but maybe it'll be time to upgrade soon. It's all about money. Enjoying a track here that I saw on the speaker testing tweeter replacement video from MaxX Arcade. He's actually quite good at finding really good music that not a lot of people have listened to on YouTube. But I'm not really in with any SoundCloud gangs, so tracks can often be really popular on there and nowhere else. Anyway, here we have my bedroom, and what is the basic state of it at the moment, guys? As you know, my bed always looks like that. I never sleep in my bed. Down there is my gaming pile of stuff left to sell. The sofa has not been touched in a long time, so that's not going to be touched. I want to sort out that area, which is, you know, all the display, the remnants of me delving in my lighting box for something, and all the DVDs. Yeah, I still have to do that wedding video, guys. It's really dragging out now. It's a pain in the ass, to be honest. Not the video itself. The video is done. Just the DVDs and stuff. It's so much effort. Little bit of a tidy over here as well. This is the main priority, actually, getting the desk sorted. So I think I'm going to do the desk first. And of course, there is also quite a bit of mess over here. But this should only be like half an hour's work if I knuckle down to it. Trouble is, I get really distracted all the time. So I'm going to ban myself from recording any more vlog clips until the desk is tidied, unless I find something really cool to talk about. Well, guys, I said I wasn't going to record another clip, but I've been making good progress. I've only been at this for like 10 minutes. I'm trying to like tidy things up. I've got way too much crap. But one thing that I'm annoyed at the moment, if I just take a seat, is having this monitor here kind of ruins my whole corner lamp thing. So I'm starting to wonder whether it'll be a good idea to transfer the lamp from there to that corner. But then that corner's really handy for leaning my CDs, but that's no big deal anyway. So I'm going to toy around with a couple of different things with the lamp. And I'll see if I come up with any kind of thing, because the cable only goes this far, right? And I can't be bothered to get the cable up from behind there. That's just going to be stressful. I could send it down there, I suppose. But anyway, there's no effort to go here anyway. So, yeah. And the display, you know, it can be pushed back and stuff. But, yeah, I want the display there. It's going to be great for testing purposes. Just wish it went a little bit higher, actually. I could get it. Actually, that would impact on the projector screen then, wouldn't it? So that wouldn't be good. Although, the projector screen starts just above this blue tack, so... yeah, I would like it to go higher. Guys, I think that's how we're gonna have it. Obviously, that crap won't be there, but for now, that is good. Basically, all I've really got is obviously, you know, deodorant. I had quite a few weird comments about my deodorant in the last couple of videos. I don't know why. I got my lamp. Also, CDs. These are basically CDs that I've either borrowed off someone and I need to give back, or CDs. Sorry, guys, bloody hell, I'm not even pointing the camera in the frame. oh, dear. Or CDs that, you know, were presents or whatever. For instance, that was a present. For instance, I should have said. Don't know what that is. I don't know what half of them are. Basically, I put all of my audio CDs in a big box upstairs in the attic because they're all ripped. And these are ones that just need to find a home, really. Got my Dalek, keeping them safe because I really like my Daleks. Center channel for the surround system. All my stationery, so pens, pencils, scissors, fork, giant pencil. Giant pen rather, ruler, markers, torch in case of emergencies, Pritt stick because it's stationary and I have it there and it looks cool. I love the design of these things. These are great. Put it like that. And blue tack behind there in case I ever need to stick something to something really quickly. Obviously I need to do a lot of dusting, guys, but that gives me a very free area for my test bench. Move all this crap out the way and yeah. Really, really free there to get systems up on the desk and fiddle about with them. If I had it my way, I'd have nothing at the back, but you know, it's just not practical to have nothing at the back, so this is looking good. This is okay. So it's time to cable up. I have got everything I need. I've got a brand new VGA cable, brand new DVI cable, brand new Keter lead, zip ties,
and of course a pair of snips. I got all these with my U2412Ms and I've still got a spare set, so this is absolutely great. I do have spare cables like this hanging around upstairs, but it's just easier to get these and they're brand new and I know they're working and there's no bent pins and stuff. So I'm going to run power to this monitor from the extension lead that I have under here, which does not interrupt my main setup in any way. And then I'll also have DVI and VGA for testing purposes of both kinds of display outputs. So if I'm testing a graphics card or whatever on a system, then it's going to have DVI. If I'm testing in built-in graphics, it's going to have either DVI or VGA. So, you know, I won't be short of anything. So it's time to wire this thing up. So here they are, the cables are all run. I've decided to run USB as well because it'll be very handy. My plan is to buy a wireless keyboard just for testing purposes. Wireless keyboard and mouse combo with like a trackpad on it. So for testing newer systems and stuff, that would be really great. So I'm going to put the wireless receiver in the bottom of the monitor here. And then I'll have this USB cable and I'll have it all in one big bunch and I can plug it into the back of the system for testing. So that'll give me a keyboard and mouse. And then that'll just be a small little unit that I can keep under there on top of my surround sound processor. And I can pull it out, stick it on the desk, and that is easily done. As you can see, DVI and VGA for the full flexibility, as well as, of course, the plug. And also another plus of doing that is it gives me two USB ports on the side of the monitor for extra USB if I need it for testing purposes. But what I'm going to do now is pull these cables through, make them neat, do some cable tie magic, and I'll have to empty my bin and stuff like that down there before I run the power cable along. Got some stuff to do back there, so it'll be a little while before I do that. I'll get the rest of the room sorted. I may not run it today, but because I have to pull all this out to run it along the back. But as long as I get the cables down the side there, that's all that matters. And in case you're wondering, guys, these cables will just be sitting down the side, which is cool. So they'll just sit down and I'll just pull them when I need them. They can just bunch up nicely behind the desk. No one will see them, which is great. And I've just received a text message. Well, guys, as you can see, clean job. All the cables neatly tucked under there. Let me turn this down a second. And the power cable is going down at the moment. It's just sitting down behind my desk. I haven't plugged it in. And here I've made sort of like a cable tied multi-core, if you like, with DVI, VGA, and USB on the end. All that's left to do now is for me to ravel this up. And I will keep it tied, just tucked under that little gap there. So when I need it, I can lift it up, whatever that noise was. I've got a detachable cable tie that I'll be using to keep it in place. If I can find it. All right, guys, so this cable tie on here is detachable. It is all raveled up, and check this out. Just throw it down the back, like that. Out of sight, out of mind. When I need it, hand down the back, grab it, job done. There is my new test setup. Clean as hell. And the desk as a whole is complete. Much more clutter-free, or much less clutter, either way you want to say it. Still not overly happy with this section here, you know, it's still a bit cluttery, but so much better than it has been in the past. The top of this little filing, you know, I've got all my business documents and all sorts in here. This is such a handy little, you know, drawer thing, it's really great. This has become my dumping ground of stuff on top of here, which, you know, makes sense. It's quite a cool area, and I don't think it looks messy, it just looks as if it's stuff in progress, you know. If I find a missing screw or a broken piece off something and I'm not too sure what it's come off, I always stick it up here, and it has come in handy two or three times now, so that's really great. And check this out, guys, so chuffed with this now. Perfect working area for computers and stuff, with a test monitor. I think I'm going to nip on Amazon now and order the keyboard. I've also, this area is much more cluttered free. What I think I might do is put that coaster there. Does that look better? I don't know, sometimes I've got two drinks up here at the same time, see guys, but I'm going to keep it like that. Now, the desk, this bit does look more cluttered than usual, because of all the SD cards and all this stuff over here and all this stuff over there. But what you've got to remember is these displays will be floating soon, so there'll be no stands, so it'll look much less cluttered. And the N64 is still chilling there. It actually looks as if this is a dedicated N64 setup. It's not. The N64 is still connected to the center monitor. Anyway, I'm going to order a keyboard for this setup.
So I thought one of these all-in-one trackpad keyboard things would have been good for, you know, testing purposes, because they're small and convenient, and I can slip the USB dongle into the bottom of the display, and happy days, everything is great. The Logitech one that I instantly went to look at, I was going to get, I thought it was like £20, But it turns out it's like $27.99, so I decided to get one that's $14.99 from a different brand that's got 4 out of 5 stars with 80 reviews, and pay a little bit for delivery, $3.99 for first class, so I get it in the week so that I can make a video about my test bench setup. Or my sort of PC testing setup, I should call it, really, because test bench is used to sort of describe something else.
If you don't know what I mean, it's basically one of these. It's got a keyboard there and a trackpad on it as well, so that'll be great. I can have the USB dongle slipped in there and just have the keyboard under there, and when I need it, I can whip it out.
Now, obviously, for older systems, I'll need a PS2 keyboard, so I'll also keep one of those handy, but the only, you know, quick and easy thing to do there is to keep one close by and plug it in when needed. So, you know, but the mouse, the trackpad should work fine for pretty much any age system, unless I'm working on really old stuff. But if I'm working on really old stuff, then I won't mind whipping out specific mouse and keyboard to use that, because, you know, that's totally fine by me. I can also test Macs on this setup, of course, and the setup could come in handy for all sorts of other things. I was thinking, like, when I do my live streams, not that I do that many, but I can tether my laptop to my internet on the phone, or to my 3G, so that I can monitor the chat and do all of my monitoring and browsing on the MacBook or whatever, or vice versa, use the MacBook to stream, and, you know, there's all sorts of different things, but the display is there handy. It's a really handy setup. I've got another spare 2009W now, but I'm not selling it. I've had a few people asking if I'm selling it. I am not. I've done a bit of posting to the older social media, which I'm doing quite a lot this weekend, actually. I go in phases of doing it and not doing it, guys. But I've posted about, you know, talking about my desk setup, and I've posted an Instagram post of this new puppy. So time is ticking, guys, and the room is still quite a tip. It is 3:15, so what I'm going to have to do is tidy it up pretty quickly. You know, nice quick tidy, just not a perfect tidy, just something, you know, something decent. Just so that I can record my rant video about Splatoon, about the test fire, people's reaction to the test fire. And it won't be a very popular video probably, because IMNC rants is, you know, moderately popular. I'm getting a fresh glass, by the way, guys, because there's something weird on the bottom of this one. I'm not too sure what. I'll sort it out in a second later before I go. IMNC rant, moderately popular. Gaming videos on my channel lately, diabolically unpopular. Wii U videos, somewhere in the middle. So I want to get some of my gaming audience back. So I will be doing some gaming things. I remember the exact gig and the exact pub where I got this pint glass from. Yes. So I want to build my gaming audience back up. It's kind of important to me because I used to do so much gaming stuff when I started It's My Natural Colour, and I'd hate to lose my gaming audience. But, you know, I've got a few people that are still here because of gaming, which is great. But anyway, talking aside, I need to get on with it. Jack just posted another snap of a closer shot of the desk, and I actually saw that it was a Behringer X32. And he said, in the snap, it said, not a fan of this desk. So it's quite shocking that Jack doesn't like that desk. I'll have to give him a ring soon and have a catch-up and ask him why he doesn't like it, because I think the X32 is phenomenal. But we will see what he says about it.
Well, guys, my parents have just come back, and my dad found an awesome find. My wallet is here. Hang on a sec. Let me just plop this down out of the way. Whoops. Check this out, guys. This is cool. I wish I would have had this before I did my Game Boy video, but still, nevertheless, still very, very cool. This is a... Sorry about the bad camera work for a second, guys. Hang on a sec. There we go. Should have opened it before I started recording. This is a third-party case, but in here we have a nice original Game Boy, which is awesome, and it is working. I've tested it. I've tested it with the game. And as you can see, it's all in separate little compartments, which is great. Got Tetris in its little thing, and it was only a tenner, which is awesome. So this is definitely very cool. I very much look forward to seeing what kind of money I can get for this, and I have plenty of games, plenty of spare Game Boy games, to add in the bundle to make it very, very appealing, which is great. Now, guys, one interesting thing. I've got my copy of Tubular Bells on there that I keep meaning to take up to the studio. I need to plop that there. I was listening to that the other day on my dad's mini gram downstairs. Awesome, awesome sound. It was really cool, but I want to take it up and keep it safe for the rest of my record collection now. There will be some stuff to come on turntables, by the way, guys, so keep your eyes peeled for that. Or your ears peeled, rather. Yes, now some little update to give you. It is 16:24, and unfortunately the day has kind of carried me away. The room is still not tidy, and I have still not recorded Tuesday's video, so my plan now is to take the iMac back up to the studio out of the way for a second, get all this stuff sort of moved so that I have enough space to record Tuesday's video, and just nail the recording, and then hopefully I'll be done by sort of 5, half 5.
Boom, it is 5 o'clock and I am all recorded. I said I wasn't going to edit this today, but I'm just going to drop it in the timeline to get started. There it is, a 13 minute clip, should cut down to roughly about 11 and a half minutes, hopefully. Maybe 11 minutes. I didn't want it to be that long, but whatever. I'm just going to slap it in the timeline and fiddle about with it a little bit. Yeah, because I actually use my camcorder for these types of videos, by the way, guys. That's why they're a little bit different looking to some of my other videos. It's all to do with focus and stuff of this camera. This camera does a lot better, but it always means that I've got to get someone to manually focus and stuff just because I just can't do it with my eyesight. So, yep, it's kind of hard, but whatever. I've had a lot of people asking me what I've been doing lately to my clips where I've been sitting in front of the desk setup. Now, this clip isn't centered properly. I'm having issues with my tripod. The screens are actually sloping downwards, as you can slightly see, but it's all okay. Now, what do I do? I'm still perfecting all of the correction that I do to this kind of footage, and it'll change when I start to use a different camera for these types of videos. But what I think I've perfected this time, and I think it'll look the best, some other videos have had the filter on and they've looked pretty rough. But I've got the controls over here. The first thing I did was a colour correction to bring up the saturation and also bring up the brightness of the clip in general, but bringing down the mid-range. Sorry guys, I'm not a video guy, I'm an audio guy. Bring down the sort of mid-range of the whole white balance type thing. So yeah. It basically does that. It brightens everything up. You go from this to that, and it looks a lot better, okay? And then I add the classic teal and orange effect, but just a tiny dash of it. I have overused it in previous videos. A tiny dash of it here. And you can't really notice a difference on the camera. You can just see, if you look at my face, if you look at my skin, it brightens up my skin tone nicely, and it looks great. And then, of course, a big secret, which is... hang on a sec, where is it? Here, this guy, just to center me a little bit more and make blur out all the corners, which makes it look awesome. So that's my settings as they stand at the moment. Hopefully you can see that really does make a lot of difference, not to everyone's taste, but definitely to my taste. Looks beast. And you'll notice the teal and orange a little more now, like that. So yeah. I'm not going to edit this video in this little section, but... ooh, and also my changing LEDs, I keep forgetting to do it, but I mean to turn them either off or set them to one colour, because sometimes they can throw the camera's white balance and exposure a little bit when they change colour. But like that, looks great. And yeah, I am done with this video for now. Command Q. Bye-bye. If you're going to go. Hello? Anybody? Hey, anybody home? Here we go. Yay.
Well guys, quick change of clothes because it's boiling in here and I've actually been sweating quite a bit doing some of this work. Nice fresh t-shirt and shirt, and it's actually turned sunny outside, which is awesome. It looks like an entirely different day. But anyway, I'm going to go and chill out and watch some films and just enjoy my Sunday evening. So I will catch you guys tomorrow. And tomorrow I'll probably be in a little bit of a worse mood because it's a work-filled day. But anyway, I do enjoy my job. I actually love my job, so I shouldn't be complaining too much. I shall see you guys tomorrow. Good day, everyone. It is Monday. Good day. What an interesting, you know, expression. It's very British, isn't it? Good day. I am turning on my Mac Pro and preparing to edit Tuesday's video, I think. It is... hang on a sec. Let me get you the update.
It is 11:42 on this Monday morning. The weather, if you want a weather update, grey, cloudy, not cold, not particularly windy, not raining.
So sort of like totally neutral weather. I've just arrived home and I've had a nice lie-in this morning, bank holiday lie-in. What did I do last night then? Oh yeah, just watched TV, chilled out. It was nice, you know? It was really nice. I'm happy, I'm doing okay. I'm doing all right.
Got my legendary iMac G3 cup here with some lovely proper coffee inside. And this is a good example of why I need the two coasters. I often have a water and a coffee because I have to drink lots of water. I know I've been speaking about this loads in this vlog. What the hell is wrong with me? But the thing I was saying about fizzy drinks applies to hot drinks as well. If I have a cup of tea or cup of coffee and I don't have a glass of water either sort of half an hour after it or with it, I get a headache. And that's just the way it works. So it's quite good, really, because it's keeping myself sort of healthy, I guess.
But when I see those people that can just drink tea and coffee constantly and they never have a glass of water, like, ever, I struggle to know how they survive, you know, just because I just cannot function without water, which is kind of crazy. But anyway, I think today is going to be a crazy hair day, so I'm going to cram in a shower and probably a shave before work, because the beard is getting a bit extreme. And I never really set out to have a beard, guys. It just sort of arrives, and I kind of like it, so it stays. Anyway, I am editing my rant video, and I'm a bit nervous to upload it. I always am with these rants, but... Oh, I can see one editing mistake that I've made from here. Okay, that's cool. Cancel that. Yeah. It's always interesting when you quickly look away from a project. Sometimes you can see mistakes that you've made, you know, it's crazy. Yes. The only downside is about doing an overall, as I showed you guys yesterday, the colour correction and stuff, is obviously I have to re-render the whole clip. It doesn't take very long because it's in the appropriate format, but, you know, re-rendering 13 minutes, it does take a little bit of time, and that's why I'm looking forward to getting the Hackintosh up and running, is because it will be quite a bit faster at things like rendering, exporting and stuff like that. My Mac Pro is totally fast enough for me on a day-to-day basis. If anything, I still can't utilize most of its speed. But, you know, when you really see that kind of thing come into play is with rendering and stuff like that. And even though the Mac Pro is technically quick enough for me, it'll make my life a lot easier to have more speed. So it's a luxury more than anything, but man, I am really looking forward to it.
12:24 and I have a successful edit of this video. Very happy. As you guys can see, I'm not fully rendered yet, and that's one thing I will say about this Mac Pro and the specific the footage that I get off this camera, or this, I actually used a different camera for this. This is 1080i footage, but both of these cameras work fine. I guess it's just Final Cut in general. I can watch my footage with minimal slowdown and edit the 1080 footage, 1080i in this instance, while it is unrendered with minimal slowdown on this 7-year-old computer, which is great, you know. And as you can see, it's rendering and it's chugging through it, so that's pretty cool. And also, I could begin exporting right now before rendering it. I don't have to necessarily wait for it to render, but I would prefer to do that. And then I'll have one preview of this again in Final Cut, and then I'll be happy. So that is that. That is what my edit tends to look like, guys. Obviously, I've shift Z'd it, which basically fills your project in the timeline. Little tip for you guys there. There is my intro. There is the IMNC intro. There's a bit of background music there, which is the same as my outro music that I use in the start of some of my videos. Very rare. Little picture as a reference, because I'm talking about something that involves a picture there. And very simple, just loads of cuts, 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 cuts all the way until the end. And then we have my outro music, outro end card with the yesterday's previous video. I always steal a clip from here, pick a random one on the previous video. And that is job done, guys, in my editing. There's really nothing that fancy about it, but I'm very happy with the way this video looks. If only my tripod was straighter, but yeah, pretty cool. Ah, guys, I've got a perfect Tom Smith stressed out shot for the thumbnail of IMNC Rant. It's always good to try and get a thumbnail that'll draw people in, and most of my thumbnails are pretty crap. That is one thing I'll be working on soon.
I'll talk about that in a second, actually, because it's been quite in the front of my mind for a little while. But yeah, just look how stressed I look. That's amazing. It's, yeah, I really like it. Could be my new profile picture on Facebook. Check this out, guys. When I tell people that I've progressed on the channel immensely in the last 6 months to a year, they don't believe me. And if I show you this thumbnail from pretty much from when I around started, 5 videos a week, just a couple of months afterwards, check this out. Look at this, guys, okay? This is a shot that I took, this is the shot that I took straight from Final Cut for the thumbnail. And what do we have here? We've got terrible lighting because I didn't get my softboxes. I had to make do with par cans. And I used to use LED and normal par cans and stuff and fire them up from the floor, and I had these terrible reflections off my glasses. It was all horrendous. It does have a cool kind of look to it, but it's all very pink as well. This is one of the better ones as well, guys. You've got, you know, my setup behind there. You can see the tripod with gaffer tape all over it, and you can see the two old monitors, and my gaming PC is there, and it's all squished up. You know, check that out versus that, you know? There's so much of a difference in such a short space of time. Anyway, I'm basically just looking for the Photoshop file just so I can copy the IMNC rant title for the continuity. New one, old one. New one, old one. Crazy difference. I haven't actually changed the necessary... hang on a sec. The fill... If I go 70... There we go. That's even better. There we go. Check that out, guys. New one, old one. New one, old one. Worlds apart. There we go, guys, at around 20 to 1 or quarter to 1 or whatever it is, I'm all previewed and happy, thumbnail made, and that is another It's My Natural Colour YouTube video in the bag.
So, I said I was going to talk about design, and I am actually talking to a great guy that I know. I don't know him too well. I know him through a great friend of mine, and he's going to work on some artwork for me. For the channel, and I am really excited to do a relaunch of my branding as a whole, really, as the a relaunch of the IMNC branding. The sort of iOS style thin text that David made me, along with his intro and now Matt's intro, they are all fantastic. In fact, there are things that I love about the new intro, the old intro, far more than my new one, but, you know, whatever. The intro thing is by the by at the moment. In terms of logos, I basically, it's a stunning logo, but it doesn't dictate me, you know? I am not that clean, spotless YouTuber that uploads total 100% quality all the time, you know. I'm not one of those big channels that does that. I do things in my own way, and one of the things that people love on the channel is the magic of what I do. And the logo and the banners do not capture that at all. So I'm gonna go for a much more artistic, like, think of my old logo, oh God. Think of my old logo, but think of it as, you know, less word art, if you like, more professional, but with that element of, yeah, you know, I'm Tom, I do my own thing, I don't care, you know, it's going to be really cool, and he's going to do it for me, and hopefully I'll get a chance to work very close with him on it for a couple of weeks. He's very busy, and I initially spoke to him about doing this about a month ago, and I'm in no rush. It could have been like 2 months ago, actually. I'm in no rush, but I am kind of eager to get my channel rebranded, and I'm really looking forward to doing it. It's something that I want to do this year anyway, so I'm not in a massive, massive rush at all, but I'm very excited. I try not to think about it, because then I get excited, and then I get tempted to message him to sort of nag him a little bit, and I don't want to do that, because I know he's busy, and yeah, but I'm looking forward to rebranding and stuff, and I've got like a mixed design at the moment. Everything is the same looking, you know, the font in the thumbnails is the same as my font in my banner, which is the same as the font in my icon and stuff, but at the same time, it's not really, it's just not me, it's not me. And that's not to say that it's bad, it's not. Everything that I have design-wise is good, apart from maybe the thumbnails I do, you know, the thumbnails are a bit lacking, but yeah, new thumbnails have come with the new design with much more IMNC goodness. You'll be able to tell it's my videos, you know, but without, you know, turning people away, because I think my thumbnails can turn people away sometimes. They say that custom thumbnails draw people in, but, you know, it's hard to notice as a YouTuber why some of your videos are less popular, but sometimes I think with the thumbnails, I'd make bad choices. And that doesn't help, and it's a nightmare to update thumbnails once they're live. They take ages to become live if you re-upload, and it's just not practical. But yeah, this vlog is already going to be as long, like really long anyway, so I don't want to totally rant loads. But just to let you know that that's in the works, and I know not everyone watches my vlogs, so it's a nice little bit of behind-the-scenes info, if you like, that IMNC will be rebranded and redesigned very soon, and that'll make me feel complete. You know, at the moment I've got a little bit of dodginess in terms of when I look at my channel, I'm like, nah, not too happy, but when I've got a fresh new banner and stuff, I'm gonna be absolutely over the moon.
Making a toasted cheese sandwich and dunking it into chicken and mushroom pot noodle is one of my favorite things to do in life, and I don't get to do it very often, so this is a very nice treat for me, and it's made me happy. Got some orange squash for a little bit of variety in my life. Nearly 10 past one. Time machine can't back up. My external drive is full. I need to sort that. It's got loads of duplicates on there though, because I've been migrating data a lot. But yes, for now I'm gonna chill out with some YouTube videos and eat this. Guys, if you haven't seen this video from Linus Tech Tips, then this is something else. He basically doesn't have the mounts to put his coolers onto his CPUs on this massive, expensive server board. And he's using cable ties and balancing the board on a cardboard box and all this crazy, crazy stuff just to fiddle around with the CPUs, even though the brackets that he needs are on the way. This is crazy, man. This is, I mean, he, you know, he's known for doing stuff like a little bit, you know, off the edge, but this is something else, and you can actually see it reflected in the likes and dislikes. Obviously, that's still a really good ratio, but he doesn't usually get this many dislikes on a video. So this is something else. Just, you know, as comparison, the CPUs and board combination here is probably worth more than everything in my bedroom put together. I believe these are like $4,500 CPUs, and he's got two of them, and they're not even held into the sockets because he's removed the mounting hardware and the retention thing, and he's just using cable ties to hold the cool. My God, I just, no way, I could not do that. It's so scary. I'm not slagging him off or anything, guys. You know, he's massively successful, but holy crap, that would still, even if I had this stuff given to me like he does, that would still really, really make me shit myself. Holy shit, guys, he needs a counterweight, right? He just said I need a counterweight because he's balancing the motherboard off the edge of the box. Grabs what looks to be a GTX 780 maybe, and what looks to be a Titan, and just stacks them on top of this, like, ridiculously expensive motherboard. Wow.
Underneath. Much more easy. Okay.
This is amazing. Titan. He's crazy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a Titan.
Ow.
Oh my gosh, guys, whoa. I felt so strongly, guys, that I actually commented, and I rarely comment on YouTube channels of this kind of size. Yeah, I just had to get involved and say, holy crap, that was one of the most scary videos I've watched in a long time, you know? Not that it wouldn't damage me in any way, but the amount of times where he could have dropped something onto the socket and it could have just, it doesn't even bear thinking about, my God.
My lunch is complete. I am nice and full, but I am now feeling a little bit more lazy and just a little bit more, like, ugh, kind of feeling. I love my job, but since we went digital, there is not a lot of hands-on action with film now. And I've got a big splodge of something on my glasses, I just realised. I think it's pot noodle from somewhere. Oh man, you may even be able to see that on the video. Anyway, oh, I gotta clean it off, I can barely see. So since we went digital in work, there is a lot less hands-on work in terms of the cinema side of things. Now, it is a cinema/theatre, but theatre is kind of rare. The shows, you know, it can have popular times like Christmas and stuff, but the main work that I do up there is cinema related. And with digital, you don't really need to do anything. Once everything is ingested, once all of the films and the adverts and the trailers are ingested and the playlists are built and the scheduling is in place, then there is nothing to really be done. And we really just go up there to switch everything on, and we still manually run the shows in the main auditorium with the curtains and the lights and everything. But it could be totally automated if you wanted it to be. So we are not really needed. When I say we, I mean us three projectionists. So in the film days where, you know, you had to lace up the machines and sometimes you had different films in one day, so you'd be swapping over films and just all the stuff that comes with film projectors, you know, changing lenses if you had, you know, scope and flat and all this stuff. It just all hands-on work, not to mention the maintenance that you'd have to do off showtime. You know, so much cooler than digital. But then, you know, I do respect digital and I'm not just a big hater of it, so it's all good. But I do, when it comes to these half-term shifts where I'm there until, you know, sometimes it's a lot earlier, sometimes it's 11 until, you know, sometimes it's a 12-hour. But today there's only films at 3 and 7.15, so I'll be there from 2:30 until about 10 at night. But when I do these long days, it gets to me a little bit because there's not loads to do. But the advantage to that is I'm being paid to be there, and also I, at the same time, can do, like, YouTube work in terms of replying to messages and emails and stuff, which is exactly what I want to do today. That would be really, really great because I do have about 47, I think that says, emails to reply to. I did have a massive, massive go through them a couple of days ago, which was great. But I've got the 47 emails to reply to, and I've also got loads of Facebook messages. So I hope to get on top of them today. 2 o'clock. I've been sucked into the void of YouTube once more. I didn't get to, you know, get rid of my beard or anything, but that's okay. That's totally okay. I'm going to go and sit in work now for the rest of the day. It takes me about 15 minutes to walk. I need to be there by 2:30. My shift starts at 2:30, so I'll leave at 2:15. That gives me 1/4 hour to get myself ready. Well, 14 minutes now. To get myself ready and organised, ready to go. Which is cool, because all I need to do is pick up my bag, put on my coat, put on my beanie, and take a walk. I normally cycle. My bike is already up there. Well, one of my bikes. I have two bikes. I have a BMX and I have a mountain bike. I normally dart back and forth to work on my BMX. That's currently up there. If I ride to work on my mountain bike now that I use for longer journeys, then that means I'll have two bikes up there and I'll only be able to ride one back. So my plan is to walk up and ride my bike home. Sometimes I leave it up there, you know, if it's like raining or whatever, and then someone offers me a lift, I sometimes go for it. But I've got to get out of that habit because that means I am then stuck without my bike. For the next time I have to go up, it's literally been up there for about 2 or 3 weeks now. Whoops. But yeah, it is what it is. So about 13 minutes past 2, my video is uploading for tomorrow. Today's is already uploaded. I will not be taking you to work. I'm sorry, guys, but it's going to be pretty boring. Just me sitting there doing my work stuff and answering emails. So yeah, I don't have a work uniform clean, so I'm just going to go like this. And everything is gravy. I will probably give you guys an update tomorrow because I'm going to be stuck here for the rest of the day. Not stuck. I do enjoy it. Just a little bit stuck. But it's okay. I'd kind of like to stay here though. I could really work on the Hackintosh and stuff. But whatever. I'm not going to rant. It's time for me to go. See you guys tomorrow. What is up, guys? Whoa. What a weird noise. It is Tuesday. I've literally just come home. And as soon as I walked through the door, I forgot to take my shoes off. There we go. As soon as I walked through the door, I went upstairs, and then I heard a knock on the door, and then I went downstairs, opened the door, and there was like a lad down there. He looked like 16. And he was like, "Oh, a parcel for Thomas Smith?" And I was like, "Yep, that's me. Nothing to sign, nothing like that." And he just gave me the parcel, which I assume is my keyboard and mouse combination. So let's take a look at it. Here it is, folks. I've turned it over because the of course the address is on the other side. Is this side even openable? Oh, this is gonna be hard. Oh, it's okay. Let's have a look. Ah, Come on.
Ordering a product and having it arrive in the same day, in the same vlog is pretty good. Hey, awesome. Here it is, guys. Looking forward to trying this out. It looks quite nice. Not bad, not bad for a cheapo thing. And got a pen drive here. That's cool. And I believe that's it. There's no secret copy of Splatoon lurking in here. So here it is, guys. Looks like a nice little unit. Trackpad is nice size. Buttons are a bit squishy, but it's okay. It's only for testing. Keys actually feel quite nice for what it is. Comes with a little USB dongle, of course, which I'm going to plug in underneath my monitor. This is the whole point of getting this wireless setup. There we go. Awesome. That can sit under there. Great. And I am going to unpeel this film. Come on. Now, I didn't know it was glossy when I ordered it, guys, but you can't win them all. Beggars can't be choosers. For the money, you can't really go wrong. Oh, my camera's got low battery. Excellent. That's okay. I'll charge it a little bit later. There we go. Nice little keyboard. Looks great. Great for a test setup. Lovely. So what is happening today in my life, guys? Well, as you guys know, there is no cinema work on a Tuesday for me, normally. Sometimes in the morning, but, you know, that's rare. Well, I don't know, kind of rare. So today, at about 1 o'clock, I'm meeting up with a friend of mine, which should be great for a nice catch-up. That'll be awesome. Been looking forward to this. And after that, at around 4 o'clock, I have a studio session. Gonna be drumming on some tracks in the studio down the road, which is awesome. Haven't been given the tracks yet, don't really know what they are, but that should be fun. Gonna do that for a couple of hours and then chill this evening. Today's video is made and ready to rock. Tomorrow's video is not made. I could do it now. It is 11:44 and getting picked up at 1. I could do it now, but I'm not gonna rush it. I'll see how I feel, actually. I'll put my camera battery on charge and see if I can at least get a bit of it filmed or whatever, but I'm not going to wear myself out, and I do want to have a shower and shave and that because I didn't manage to accomplish that yesterday. So, yeah, that would be pretty good, to be honest. Today is turning out to be a pretty wicked day, guys. I'm enjoying myself. I'm in a really good mood. Just got back from a lovely catch-up with a great friend. Had a nice McDonald's. It was really cool to see her again. After all this time, we should definitely do it more often. 20 to 4. It's 20 to 4 now. I am getting picked up in about 20 minutes' time to go down to the studio and do some recording, which will be really cool. Playing drums on a few tracks, like I told you this morning. So, not doing anything specifically YouTube-related today, other than giving you guys a couple of little vlog updates. But there is more fun stuff to come. Today I've got my IMNC Rants video going live, and tomorrow's video will be about my new setup that I've got here, now that I've got my keyboard in place. I am also thinking of another cool little thing to do with this setup, actually, guys. I thought of it earlier. All of the wiring is in place to test a system. It's just right behind here, as I showed you guys. But the only thing that isn't here is a power cable for the system. So I thought it would be really cool to either run an IEC cable up here and have it trailing here so that I can just pull it up like that and plug the IEC into the back of the system. Or, because some systems have proprietary PSUs and stuff, like Mac Minis or laptops or whatever, I guess, I thought it would be even cooler if I could somehow get a 13-amp socket or even a row of 13-amp sockets on here. So what I may do is get a 13-amp extension lead. I hate white ones. I'll get a black one and just mount it to sort of here so that I can plug things in also. So if I need to test various devices, just plug them in there. I've got a monitor, I've got my keyboard and mouse, and everything is good. I am really liking this, and it's something that I should have done a while ago, but of course, I guess I had spare monitors to do it with, but it's very handy with these Dells because they're nice quality and big enough for me to see and everything. So yeah, this will be really great. I'm feeling good about it. So I'll make a dedicated video about it tomorrow, and of course I'm sure you guys will have lots of good suggestions in that video. And then this vlog will be going live on Thursday, but there'll be lots more vlog goodness to come. One thing I haven't had the chance to do is import any clips from this vlog. They're all still on the SD card, so I have no idea how long this vlog is. I've got a feeling it's really long, but it's also
also probably a little bit more entertaining than some of my previous ones that have been going a little bit downhill in my opinion, but shh, don't tell anyone. My life is not getting more boring, I promise. But anyway, guys, before I ramble on any longer, I'm going to have a little chill, and then I'm going down the studio to record some tracks, so I'll catch up with you guys later. What is up, guys? 11:52 on a Wednesday. I didn't give you guys another update yesterday. Basically, I did some recording. It all went pretty well. And my friend down the studio, he has a broken computer monitor. He runs a dual screen setup, one Apple 27-inch display, I think it is, and a secondary monitor, and it's just gone down the drain. So I said I'd lend him one of my Dell 2009Ws, you know, long-term loan type thing. I don't need it, it's in my way. So I've just dug out the stand now and I've clipped it on.
As you guys know, I'm using one on the test setup, obviously, and he's coming to pick this up later on sometime. So yeah, I may give it a little clean if I've got time, but there it is, back on its stand. You know, it's kind of, this is the original one that I had. I kept the second one that I bought because it had slightly better picture. This is the second one. This is the original one. Man, the camera is not focusing today, is it? Whoa. Excellent. This is the original one that I had. Hang on, guys. I gotta sort this. So this is the original one that I bought, and this was my first ever decent computer monitor, guys. You can go all the way back to 2010 to watch the unboxing of this. But it has served me very, very well. It's a nice bit of kit, really nice monitors.
So that's that out of the way. That monitor is by the front door, waiting to be collected. It is 11:41, guys, and unfortunately I had a bit of an avalanche out of my wardrobe and I looked for the monitor stand, but that's okay, it needs tidying anyway. My room is in desperate need for a tidy, but I haven't got time to do it today. I've got work, I've got to leave for work around 2 today. A little bit earlier than Monday, so I leave around 2. I've got a nice dinner, all I've got to do is heat it up in the microwave, so I'm going to heat it up at 1:30, and eat my dinner and get ready in that 30 minutes. So that gives me a little bit of time to record today's video and edit it and export it and stuff. So today's video is going to all be about my test bench setup. But the really cool little twist I've got is today I picked up a Mac locally. A new Mac. It's not terribly exciting, but the fact that I picked it up locally for £20 is pretty cool, which is a rare occurrence, you know. But unfortunately, it's just an 800 megahertz Quicksilver, just like the other two that I have. Not sure if it's dual 800, that's left to be seen, but that means I've had 3 Quicksilvers in a row now, all 800 megahertz. I didn't know the spec of any of them, and they all turned out to be 800 megahertz. So that's something, but the video will be more evolving around the test bench setup, and then I'll make a specific video about the Quicksilver, which will be cool. So yeah, I'm going to make that now. It's not going to be crazy long or anything. It'll just be a nice little video, I think.
12:41, and I've managed to successfully edit my video, film it. Everything is cool. Thumbnail is done. Thumbnail is looking good. It doesn't look that washed out on the camera. You can actually read what's on the screen. So just waiting for it to export now. So it shouldn't be too long. I will definitely get this uploading in time before I go to work. I have no doubts about that. Really pleased with this video, actually, guys. Turned out well. One take, the whole lot. As you know, normally I'm one take, but one take the whole lot and it was smooth, you know. Wasn't really stumbling over my words or anything today. I've been a bit stumbly in some videos recently, not too sure why, but this video went really well, and it's about a cool little topic that I think people will like as well, so really pleased with how it's come out. Really pleased.
And just like that, guys, with the magic of the wonderful, wonderful Final Cut Pro 10, I am here today, an entire day later, more than a day later, at 7:30, and I checked the time before I started recording this clip. I am knackered. I don't know if you guys can hear by my voice. I'm very tired. The last update clip I gave you when I was editing that video and stuff, when the video was exporting, was yesterday before work. So it's Thursday night at the moment, and I'm getting this vlog exported so that I can upload it overnight. As you guys know, it is very long, and if you've made it to the end, then I really, really do appreciate it. Unfortunately, I had a bit of a rough day yesterday. I don't know what was wrong with me. I was feeling a bit under the weather. I think I ate something pretty dodgy from the chippy next door to work during work. And then in the night, I was feeling dodgy to the point where I was actually messing up a little in work. So I did a couple of little stumbles. you know, with in work, during work and stuff, and I wasn't feeling that great. And I had a very, very bad night's sleep last night. And then today, I had to get up, record today's video, which is not my best video at all. Today's video, I ended up doing it about the donation and stuff, because I didn't have time to edit this vlog, and I didn't have time to film the fun video I wanted with my dad. And then I had to go straight down the studio, and I've done 6 hours down the studio today, or I think 5 hours down the studio of drumming on some more tracks. So I've been full on, and it's 7:30 at the moment. This video is going to take ages to export, but once it's exported, I'll be happy. In fact, this is my last little bit of work that I've got to do. I'm on the home stretch because I've got no more videos to make this week. I do have a little bit of work tomorrow. I've got work tomorrow afternoon in the cinema. I've got things that I need to do on the weekend. I need to do a lot towards part 5 because I want to get that live next week. But in terms of this vlog, huge thank you for watching, everyone. By the way, the Dell 2009W is working out well in the studio, so it's nice to know that someone's using it and it's not just sitting around with me doing nothing. And of course I'm using one as well. The majority of this vlog has been about the damn test bench setup, but I am really pleased with it. I am so tired, guys, so I'm gonna sign off. Thank you very much for watching this vlog. This week has been a very, very good week. I'll remember this week for a long time, partly because of this really long vlog that I was vlogging the entire thing, and partly because of the awesome donation and just everything that happened, you know. Awesome setup. Everything was really, really cool. Really cool. I've thoroughly enjoyed myself. Of course, tomorrow I'm expecting delivery of Splatoon, which is awesome. Cannot wait. I may make a video about it. Who knows? But anyway, until next time, guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you all have a fantastic weekend. Expect that fun video I was going to do with my dad next week sometime. Part 5 next week sometime, I really hope. Had a push early the week after. But anyway, I'm done talking. Cheers, guys, and I'll see you in Monday's video.